Hi students, now let's talk about the quantifiers in the first order logic. Okay, so actually I said this quantifiers are one of the basic elements of this first order logic. So let's see what is this quantifiers. A quantifiers is a language element. Okay, we call it as a language element which generates a quantification. So these are the symbols that permit to determine or identify the range and scope of the variables and the logic expression. So here the quantifiers is just permit to determine or to identify the range as well as the scope, the range of your symbols, elements that and the scope of the elements of the variables in the logic expression. Whatever the statement that the sentence we are taken, so in that the variables that are present in that sentence, okay, so this quantifiers is going to identify the range and scope of those variables. Actually the quantifiers are of two types. One is the universal quantifier and another is the existential quantifier. Universal quantifier, it's just it's nothing but the for all, everyone, everything. So it is within the range. It determines or identify the range of the variable. Means if a particular range is given to a variable, so it deals with for all in that particular range, everyone in that range, everything in that range. If you are talking about those concepts, then you have to represent the sentence with the universal quantifier. Then what about the existential quantifier? The existential quantifier deals about the scope. Okay. It's just for some. Okay. At least one. That whenever you're talking about for some or at least one, you have to represent that in the existential quantifier. Now let me explain you what is this universal and the existential quantifier in detail. So I said the universal quantifier is a symbol of logical representation which specifies that the statements within its range, okay, a statement that is present within its range is true for everything or every instance of a particular thing. When you're talking about a statement that is true for everything or every instance of a particular thing, that if it is true, then you say that that statement you can represent it by using the universal quantifier. The symbol for universal quantifier is just, this is the for all. Okay, so actually just the reverse of A, the reverse of A, you call it as a universal quantifier. So in universal quantifier, we use the implication symbol. If you want to represent some statement, two statements, you have to use this implication symbol. Suppose if X is a variable, okay, X is a variable, then for all X, that is the universal quantifier X is read as this. Universal quantifier X, you can read it as for all X, for each X, for every X that is present which within the range. If it is true, then for all X, for each X and for every X. Okay, so whenever these type of statements are coming in this statement, then you have to represent that variable as universal quantifier X. Now let's see the existential quantifier. The existential quantifier is represented as, it's just reverse of E. Okay. It is a type of quantifier which expresses that the statement within its scope is true. Whereas the universal quantifier is within its range is true. Okay. If it is within its range is true, then you have to represent those statements as an universal quantifier. And existential quantifier which expresses that the statements within its scope is true for at least one instance of something. There, for all, for each and for every type of statements are coming, then you have represent that variable as an with universal quantifier. And existential quantifier, if it, the statement is having the sentence like at least one instance of something. So in existential quantifier, we always use and or and conjunction symbol. Let's see the example. Suppose if x, you call this x is a variable, okay, then existential quantifier will be represented as, this is the representation, and it can be read as, there exists x, and this is represented as for all, and this is called it as there exists x. If there is exist x, then it is true. For some x, you can call these as also for some x. For at least one x. So for all these type of statement, you have to represent this symbol. There exists x, for some x, for at least x. Okay. So let's see the example of this existential quantifier. Let me means for all and exist. For all men drinks coffee. So here I'm just taking the example for the universal quantifier. So this is a statement. All men drink coffee. Whenever you're seeing the statement like all means for all x. Okay, for each x, for every x, that means this is a universal quantifier. Let's take x is a variable. I don't know what, I'm just assuming x is a variable. Here all men drinks coffee. So let's take a man. All men's are drinking coffee. So x is a variable. X1 drinks coffee and x2 drinks coffee and xn drinks coffee. Because I mentioned all means if it is that is within that range, x1, x2, x2 up to that, if it is that is in, that is present within the range, and that x here is nothing but the man. A man, X1 man, X2 man, X3 man, everyone is drinking coffee and you have to represent it with an AND symbol. So, we can write this statement as, this is a representation. This statement, all men drink coffee, that is for all X, that is a man of X, can be write as, it implies can be written as, drink X comma coffee. Who drinks X comma coffee? X is a man. X1, X2, X3. So, they drinks the coffee. So, this is a statement. This is a drink is a predicate and these are the terms. A predicate and the terms. Okay. It's a predicate and the terms. So, atomic statement. So, this is an atomic statement. Why am I saying this is an atomic statement? Because here I am not using any complex sentence like connectivities. If I am not using the connectivities, then you call it as an atomic statement. Atomic sentence. Okay, so drink X comma coffee. So here this can be called as all man drinks coffee. All man. Why I'm calling all? Because I didn't mention any particular man. X1 I didn't mention. X2 I'm not mentioned. Only X I'm mentioned. X is a variable. So all man drinks coffee. They're all X, where X is a man who drinks the coffee. So, this is an example of this universal quantifier. So, in the next video, I'll take some more examples to explain these universal quantifiers and the existential quantifier. Thank you.